Ed was born here about 70 years ago, which was 66 years before he did the greatest thing in his life, which was hire Gersh. And if you think about Gersh, an incredible editor, incredible writer, that has brought so much life to the Brooklyn community, that's what's so important about Ed's life.
Ed, you fought the good fight against Brooklyn Ridge Park, but Gersh was right. Look how awesome it is.
Now we're lucky enough to be joined by Vince DiMicelli, one of Ed's original employees, joining us via Skype. How you doing, Vince?
Hey, Gersh. Thanks for having me. It's great to be here. You know, it's incredible that technology allows us to do something like this in this day and age. I know when I first started working for Ed, the only way information got around was on paper. So this is really, really cool.
That's great, Vince, but I'm a little nervous about you in the car like that. Are you going to be safe?
Yeah, well, you know, in my almost 20 years working with Ed, I think I'm pretty confident. The most important thing he taught me was, you know, how to multitask. Holy shit!
Ed, you always did a great job of bringing in young talent while you were there. Although, you know, none of us really got big jobs around New York until Gersh arrived. I mean, Gersh really worked with us. He slaved over making our copy better. He stayed late nights. Really, it was just a role model for what all of us wanted to aspire to be, and it was awesome. And, you know, look at me now. I'm at the Daily News. Thanks, Gersh.
Ed was what you would call a racial arsonist when he was in charge of Brooklyn. But Gersh, on the other hand, when he took over, it was kumbaya, harmony, peace. Thanks, Gersh.
Good morning, yesterday. You wake up and time has slipped away. And suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind. Remember, do you remember? Misty yesteryears, the good times and the bad you've seen, and all the others in between. Remember, you remember the times of yore.